Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to cover A-SOiD or A-SED. It's a platform for creating efficient classifiers to use for behavior identification from DeepLabCut outputs. You can also utilize this with Sleap CSV outputs, but here I will show you how to do this with DeepLabCut outputs. So to get started, you will need to have A-SOiD or A-SED installed. You also need CSV outputs from DeepLabCut or Sleap and the MP4 labeled files. You also need ground truth data as annotations to train the classifier. You can use either my way or the Boris way. And all of this needs to be fed into A-SOiD. So I will show you how to do that now. So go ahead and navigate over to their GitHub page and you will find the link to their GitHub page in my video description. Now I'm just going to download the entire GitHub repo here. So after you have unzipped it, you will have to find this asoid.yml file, and this is what you will be running through the Anaconda to be able to install the environment. So this will create a new environment and install the asoid dependencies. So here I'm just navigating over to my downloads folder, to the asoid main folder, and I'm going to copy now the installation code from their GitHub right here. And this will create the environment and also install the dependencies. Okay, so it has started downloading different things. It's going to take a long while depending on your internet connection. So while this is happening, I'm going to go ahead and install some other factors that I need in order to run the A-SOiD properly. So let's open up the Visual Studio installer. So here I need to do a couple of things. I need to first make sure that I have C++ dependencies installed. So for me, I have those installed already. I'm just going to go ahead and show what I have. So the desktop development with C++, you need to make sure that you have that checked. So once you have made sure that you have installed the C++ dependencies for your correct version of Visual Studio and your version of Windows, you're going to go ahead and wait for things to download or finish downloading and installing. In the background on my terminal, I can see that the environment has been created and A-SOiD has been installed. So while I'm waiting for the Visual Studio to finish downloading things, I'm going to go ahead and activate my new environment. And then here I'm just going to type in A-SOiD app, and I'm going to leave it here because this is the command I need to run in order to bring up the GUI for the A-SOiD. So Visual Studio has finished downloading whatever it needs. And I'm going to go ahead and run the A-SOiD app in the command terminal. And what this will do is bring up this interface where you can put in your email if you want to receive newsletters from the authors of A-SOiD. Now, the first time that you boot it up, it might take a little while to start. So I'm just going to go ahead and cut to the part where the GUI is up now. And by scrolling up and down, you can see the GUI is quite clean. By scrolling through this slider, you can read about different steps that you would have to engage in to be able to train your own classifier. Now, the focus of this video is going to be on how to take your pose estimations and the annotation data and utilize that for classifying your own or training your own classifier. Next, I'm going to show you how I do my annotations, which might be different than what you have seen in other places. So here I will bring up some examples. And the example here is generic example of how you can arrange your data. The way I do my annotations is a little bit different than what the A-SOiD GitHub repository encourages. And they have an example of something called Boris, which is a Python package, allows you to annotate behaviors while you're observing the video. In this video, for example, I'm looking at a white mouse and it's in a T maze. it's doing some interesting behaviors for me, for example, wall climbing. So what I've done is I've taken that video and extracted all of the frames into a folder using FFmpeg. If you don't know how to use that, I explain some of that code in another video. Alternatively, you can always Google FFmpeg. So by extracting all those frames and then going through frame by frame, I've extracted some interesting behaviors. For example, this wall climbing behavior, which in this example I will call a rearing behavior, where the mouse goes up on its hind legs. So each one of these frames represent a certain behavior. In my case, it's a rearing or wall climbing behavior. Now what I will do is I will utilize a Jupyter script to go through this directory and parse out the frame numbers, which are at the end of each of the files here. And then from that output file, we can then start to create an annotation file, CSV file, which we can then import into our A-SOiD project. So now I'm going to utilize my Jupyter script, and I'm going to go ahead and run the script, which will perform a search algorithm, and it will take all of the frames that are present in that directory which pertain to a certain behavior, and it will create a CSV output file which will have three columns. The column number one will contain a starting position for the event, such as this one, rearing behavior, and the stop, and then the length for that behavior. I will share this Jupyter script in the link below. And by the way, you can also change the extensions of your files. For example, if you're working with JPEG, you can change the MPG to JPEG. So after running this in my working directory, I will see an output, this one, this output file. And this output file has the starting position and the stop position and the length of the behavior frames. So the next part that I have to do is I have to take this length column and change it to the behavior. So by behavior, I mean whatever behavior these frames represent. In my case, these are rares. So I'm going to just go ahead and change all of the lengths to the behavior. Okay, so now this output file can be utilized in the next step of the code. And what this code will do is it will convert the output CSV to the one hot encoded and change all of the frame numbers to the timestamps as a 0.1 second interval. So let's go ahead and run this. So in the folder here, you can see new CSV is generated, and this is what the output will look like. The column A is the indexes, column 2 is time, and then the behavior. Now, one thing I do have to mention that you have to change the time to a lowercase t, otherwise the A-SOiD will not recognize the timestamps. Let's go ahead and check on the behaviors, typing in 1, because ones represent the behavior that I had coded for. So wherever you see this one, those are the time steps at which the behavior occurred. So we have converted our frames to times, sampling every 0.1 seconds, and then padded around the frames where the behavior did not occur. So after you have done that, you can go ahead and take the video from which you extracted the frames and run that through your DeepLabCut project and just perform your regular DeepLabCut analysis. You will need the CSV output from your DeepLabCut and also the labeled videos for whichever videos that you have extracted your annotations from. And all of those things will then go into the A-SOiD to then start training a classifier. So what I will do is I'll go ahead and run my DeepLabCut project, and then I will cut the video to after I have extracted the CSV file from DeepLabCut and created the labeled videos. So guys, I have switched over the computer and I'm reopening my A-SOiD. My labeled videos are done here in the menu. I'm going over to upload data. And this is where we're going to create a new project. If you have a file already that you have created, you can upload that over there. But for me, this is a new project. I'm going under Browse and putting in my CSV that got generated from me analyzing the video through DeepLabCut. So here you can see that I'm putting in the DeepLabCut CSV, and it already extracts the body parts and puts them on the right side here. Likelihood values, you can filter your values based on the likelihood. The next thing I'm going to put in are these annotations. And here I've purposefully changed the name for my binary. And this is to show you that if you don't change that time to a lowercase t, it will not recognize the time column. So let's go ahead and change this to t, lowercase. And let's go ahead and save it. And I'll change the behavior name to rare because that's what I'm going to be using for classification. So now let's go ahead and re-import the binary annotation files. So this time it should work. And there we go. On the right side, we can see the samples per class that are generated. There are a few unnamed columns that are brought in and then something called others. And over here, you can just deselect anything that you don't want to be included in your classifier. In my case, there are three columns in the other, and then unnamed, there are quite a lot of things. But we're only interested in this 1410, so I'm going to go ahead and uncheck that other. Okay, so now I'm ready to save and create the output. So I'm going to go ahead and save this in my working directory. It's in my downloads folder. I'm going to press enter and it's going to go ahead and create. So now we can proceed to the next module. So going to extract features, and this time I need to first import my config file that got generated. Now the configuration file is there. Now I can move on to view my config file and make sure everything is correct here. Then moving on to extract features. This here slider is basically just for you to view how different bins change the outlook of your data. Now this has no impact on the classification itself. This is just for you to visualize. This here, however, will have impact on your classification. So pick the duration that you think the behavior is going to occur the most for. So here for me, 0.3 seconds duration is going to be fine for me. I have sampled my frames at 0.1 second intervals, and I'm extracting features from the pose estimations that I gave it. And once it's done, it's going to ask me to move on. And here I'm moving on to the active learning part. Now, guys, everything you do over here is going to matter. This is going to be iteration number 0. And you can change these different parameters to see the output. For example, here, I only ran it for 100 iterations at sampling rate of ratio of 0.06. And if I change the sampling ratio, for example, the graph down here is going to now go ahead and change. So play around with numbers and you can always come back and reclassify things that work the best for you. Let me go ahead and mess around with some numbers so you can see how different things are changing the training classifier itself. I'll make the confidence 0.8. So with max samples at 550 and confidence at 0.8, I'm getting about 90% rearing confidence for the classifier and average confidence of 45. So not bad, and we can increase that with increasing numbers of iterations. So now my average has come to about 100%, and I would say this is now overtrained classifier. But you get the idea. So play around with these numbers and generate the best classifier that you can. And many of these parameters will depend on the type of behavior that you're interested in. Also on top of that, the number of behaviors that you want your classifier to be trained for. Here I'm just showing you some examples. And the goal is just to get you familiar with the interface and to get you started with using this for yourself. As I was beginning to learn about the A-SOiD, I found it to be incredibly challenging because there's not a lot of material available on how to do this step by step. Took me a really long time, so I hope this video will be helpful for others in getting started quickly. Let's move on to refining behaviors. And on the next tab on the left there, here you can see that I already have my config file uploaded. And I'm going to go ahead and upload the MP4 file that was generated by DeepLabCut. So here, this is the labeled video that I'm uploading. And then on the right side, I'm putting in the pose estimations that were also generated by DeepLabCut. And so from this part on, you can take a look at the identified behaviors by asking it to pick out some samples of behaviors. So moving on to parameters, here you can define the number of examples to refine from, and it will pick out, in my case, 5 examples, and it will display those for me after this process of extraction is done. So skipping over to the next part, after extraction is done, you can predict labels for the example videos that it's going to generate. And I have marked in my parameters to give me 5 example videos in which it thinks the behavior has occurred. So here's a nice reminder to save updates and refinements before you move on, which I will do that in a bit. But here are the behaviors it has picked out for me. Okay, not bad. Second example. This is a 4-second clip. So that's definitely wall climbing behavior. I saw that happen. And this is another example it has picked out. So overall, fairly good. Now guys, the only other thing that's left to do is to take the trained classifier and predict behaviors from novel videos that the classifier has not seen before. So that can be done here in the predict tab, and you're required to give it a smoothing window to smooth your frames and give it a CSV file that is generated by DeepLabCut, which I think should be fairly easy, as many of you watching this video would be familiar with DeepLabCut outputs. You can either use a filtered output or use just the unfiltered CSV output. So guys, that's it for this tutorial. I hope you found this to be helpful. Thank you so much for watching.